In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of piriformis. Piriformis is this muscle. This is very deep hip muscle. You don't see, but there is gluteus maximus that is covering piriformis. All the superficial muscles are removed. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important connection with other tissue. Let's talk about origin. Origin of piriformis is sacrum. But if you look carefully, piriformis does not attach on lateral surface of sacrum. Actually, it attaches on anterior surface of sacrum. Let me change angle of picture. This is anterior view. This is piriformis. You see, piriformis attaches on anterior part of the sacrum. Then it goes to femur. Origin is anterior surface of sacrum. Anterior surface of sacrum. This is one of the hip muscles which does not attach on pelvis. There are two kind of muscles. One is piriformis. The one more muscle is psoas. Okay? Psoas and piriformis do not attach on pelvis. That's why these two muscles can affect sacrum and lumbars. I would like to explain this mechanics later. Okay, I just explained origin, that is sacrum, correct? Insertion is this part. This part of femur is greater trochanter. It's on superior part of greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. There are many muscles attached on greater trochanter. Piriformis is one of them. Then let's talk about its function. Main function of piriformis is external rotation. This is one of deep lateral rotators. And there are two more functions. That is this movement. This is abduction. Abduction. Okay, and the last one is extension. Extension is back kick movement. Extension. Okay, so function of piriformis is external rotation this way, abduction this way, and extension, that is back kick movement. These are the function of piriformis, especially for movement. Because piriformis is very deep muscle that stabilizes hip joint. This is also important function. Now let's go back to origin. Since it attaches on sacrum, if sacrum gets shortened, that can pull sacrum this way. Correct? That's possibility. Sacrum does not move a lot. It has very tiny movement, like millimeter. But millimeter can be big deal, correct? So if sacrum is pulled this way, let's say it moves even a millimeter, then sacrum is connected to lumbar spines. That's why tightness of piriformis can aggravate a balance of sacrum and lumbar spines. That's why piriformis can be reason for low back pain. And there's one more important connection. There is big nerve coming from sacrum and shows up here. This is sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve shows up from inferior border of piriformis. That means when piriformis gets tight, that can create impingement on sciatic nerve. Piriformis has so important role for hip movement, hip stabilization, sacral balance, and sciatic nerve. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy and function of piriformis. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.